in your bulletin there. You can take that out and we'll follow the service of blessing to the baptism of Juan. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Beloved in the Lord, in the waters of holy baptism, the blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, cleanses us from all sin. Therefore, it is fitting that we bless this baptismal font, which shall hold the waters of mercy by which the Father grants us salvation through his Son in the Holy Spirit. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean.
Wash me, and I shall be white as snow.
Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings.
Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name.
Worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness.
The voice of the Lord is over the waters.
The God of glory thunders. The Lord over many waters.
The voice of the Lord is powerful.
The voice of the Lord is full of majesty.
The Lord sits enthroned over the flood.
And the Lord sits enthroned as King forever.
May the Lord give strength to his people.
May the Lord bless his people with peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean.
Wash me, and I shall be white as the snow.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
whom we made heaven and earth.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your great mercy, you preserved Noah and his family through the flood and led your people Israel through the waters of the Red Sea. Through the baptism in the Jordan of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to be a blessed flood and a lavish washing away of sin. Bless this baptismal font that those who are here given new birth by water and the Spirit may receive forgiveness of sins and eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless this baptismal font and all who are regenerated here by water and the Word.
Amen.
I'd like to invite the baptismal family to come forward. Continue with the service of holy baptism on page 268. Dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Matthew, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. And the Apostle Peter has written, baptism now saves you. The Word of God also teaches that we are all conceived and born sinful and are under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We will be lost forever unless delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. How are you named?
Caroline Bell.
Caroline, receive the sign of the cross both upon your forehead and upon your heart, to mark you as one redeemed by Christ crucified. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your strict judgment, you condemned the unbelieving world through the flood. Yet according to your great mercy, you preserved believing Noah and his family, eight souls in all. You drowned hard-hearted Pharaoh and all his host in the Red Sea. Yet led your people Israel through the water on dry ground, foreshadowing this washing of your holy baptism. the baptism of the Jordan of your loved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to give us its blood and lavish washing away its sins. We pray that you behold Caroline according to your boundless mercy and bless her with true faith in the Holy Spirit, that through this saving flood all sin in her, which has been inherited from Adam, and which she herself has committed since, would be drowned and die. Grant that she be kept safe and secure in the holy ark of the Christian Church, being separated from the multitude of unbelievers, and serving your name at all times with a fervent spirit and a joyful hope. So that with all believers in your promise, she will be declared worthy of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
From ancient times, the Church has observed the custom of appointing sponsors for baptismal candidates and catechumens. In the Evangelical Lutheran Church, sponsors are to confess the faith expressed in the Apostles' Creed and taught in the small catechism. They are, whenever possible, to witness the baptism of those they sponsor. They are to pray for them, support them in their ongoing instruction and nurture in the Christian faith, and encourage them toward the faithful reception of the Lord's Supper. They are at all times to be examples to them of the holy life of faith in Christ and love for their neighbor. Is it your intention to serve Caroline as sponsors in the Christian faith?
Yes, with the help of God.
God enable you both to will and to do this faithful and loving work, and with his grace fulfill what we are unable to do.
Amen.
Hear the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. They brought young children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked those who brought them. When Jesus saw it, he was greatly displeased and said to them, "Let the little children come to me and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. Assuredly I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter it." And he took them up in his arms, put his hand on them, and blessed them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Pray, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord preserve your coming in and going out from this time forth and even forevermore.
Amen.
Parents, may be seated. As Caroline cannot answer for herself, being willed that the parents and sponsors answer the questions for her. Caroline, do you renounce the devil?
Yes, I renounce him.
You renounce all his works?
Yes, I renounce them.
You renounce all his ways?
Yes, I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father, Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth?
Yes, I believe.
You believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Yes, I believe.
You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given you the new birth of water and the Spirit, and has forgiven you your sins, strengthened you with his grace for life everlasting. Amen. and made her a member of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and heir, an heir of your heavenly kingdom. We humbly implore you that as she has now become your child, you would keep her in her baptismal grace, that according to your good pleasure, she may faithfully grow to lead a godly life, to the praise and honor of your holy name, and finally with all your saints, obtain promised inheritance in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
As we sing the baptismal hymn, and you may be seated, I'll bring her around to show her off.
Thank you.
Let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Sunday of the church here is from Isaiah chapter 51. Give attention to me, my people, and give ear to me, my nation. For law will go out from me, and I will set my justice for a light to the peoples. My righteousness draws near, my salvation has gone out, and my arms will judge the peoples. The coastlands hope for me, and for my arm they wait. Lift up your eyes to the heavens and look at the earth beneath. For the heavens vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment, and they who dwell in it will die in like manner. But my salvation will be forever, and my righteousness will never be dismayed. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We chant the gradual is printed. Stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy, in the only God our Savior, in Jesus Christ our Lord, the glory, majesty, dominion, and authority, before all time and now and forever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We rise and sing the common verse on the bottom of page 1656. And it will be a bedtime, you know, for about 1 o'clock, it means bedtime because you'll never get tired. mean, it'd just be a most wonderful day. So think about when Jesus comes and he takes you to heaven, what do you think you might like most about heaven? Everything? You have to see Jesus. You have to give him a hug. And he'll hug you back. Yeah, that'd be great. So while we're waiting for Jesus to return, what do you suppose we can do while we're here, while we're waiting? Not sin? Well, that would be good if we could do that. But okay. Go to church, yeah. Read his word. We can think about all that Jesus has done to make us worthy of heaven. Remember, he took our sins, he paid for our sins, so that now we look perfect in God's eyes, and he will take us to heaven. Yeah. We can tell others about Jesus, how wonderful heaven is in. Is going to be, so they'll be a part of heaven, and we can live happy lives. You know, God's desire, as I told somebody, God's desire is not to be provided. God's desire is that we live happy lives, that we rejoice in all that he gives. Now, that doesn't mean that we don't sin and there aren't some unhappy times, but God's desire is that we be happy, and that we share that with others so they can be a part of his kingdom too. Well, we're going to talk about the end of the world here in a little bit some more, but thanks for coming up. You go to your seats and we'll sing the sermon.
Time seems to fly by so fast
is because we fill our time with so much, so many things to do, that it just seems as if time is hurrying by. We know that time is relative. Think about when you were a child, waiting for something, in the car on a trip to grandma's house, or waiting for Christmas. Unless you had something to occupy your time, it seemed as if time took forever. Back then, children didn't have as many toys and electronic playthings to keep them occupied as they do today. As we get older, we too have too many things occupying our time, which makes time seem to rush and rush and rush. As someone once said, we're not really going through time. Time is rushing at us. As we reach the end of this church year, we need to take some time, some of our already precious time, and make sure that the things on which we spend our time are things that are worthy of our time. Remember, the devil doesn't tempt you to stay away from church, to stay away from Bible class, from reading your Bible, from having personal and family devotions. Rather, he fills your time with important or more important things to do so that you don't have time for what is truly important, your relationship with Jesus. We can see this failure to recognize that our relationship with the Lord is what should be the most important part of our lives as we look at what is happening in churches around the world, in our own country, and even in our own church right here. Indeed, as we see on any given Sunday, 50 to 60% of the people that should be here find something more important to do than the end of our service. We see it happening in Sunday school, Bible class attendance, and unfortunately, it's too often that we do not realize that absenting ourselves from God's Word amounts to simply refusing the gifts and blessings God has to give. But our text today reminds us that truly our time is really not our time, but it is God's time. Remember, when God created the world, that is when he created time for us. Our text also reminds us that in God's time, he promised and fulfilled his promise as he sent a Savior for us. Verse 4 reads, "Give attention to me, my people, and give ear to me, my nation. For a law will go out from me, and I will set my justice for a light to the peoples." In God's time, he promised to send a Savior. Way back in the Garden of Eden, immediately after Adam and Eve fell into sin, God first promised to send a Savior. Before there was a Jew and a Gentile, God promised to send a Savior. When there was only Adam and Eve, God made his promise. However, God's promise was not just to Adam and Eve, but was for all people, of all places, of all time, you and I included. Likewise, as God reiterated his promise in his time, throughout history, especially to the children of Israel, his chosen people, the promise was again not just for the children of Israel, but always for all people. Yes, he would fulfill his promise to the children of Israel, the tribe of Judah, but his promise was always a Savior for all people. Our text describes God's promise as the sending of a law to be a light to the nations. Indeed, this law was Jesus. Jesus came to fulfill God's law perfectly. We talked about that in Bible class earlier at the Mount of Transfiguration when Moses and Elijah were there. Indeed, Jesus came to fulfill the law perfectly for us in our place because we are unable to do so. Jesus came as true Israel. He came to do what the whole nation of Israel could not do. He fulfilled all of God's laws perfectly, and then he gave his life on the cross for us. He suffered the eternal punishment, the wages of sin, death, punishment which should have been ours, for us in our place, and thus he became a light for all nations. Indeed, by faith in Jesus, all people have access to eternal life in heaven. Our text text is one which is spoken to the children of Israel before the Savior was born, picking up at verse 5. My righteousness draws near, my salvation is gone out, and my arms will judge the peoples. The coastlands hope for me, and for my arm they wait. The children of Israel have been waiting and continue to wait for the promised Messiah, the Savior. In our text, God says the Savior will come speedily. Now, I don't know about you, but if I have to wait a day, let alone 100 or 1,000 years, that doesn't seem speedily to me. Yet when God says he sends his salvation and it comes speedily, he fulfills his promise in his time and according to his perfect plan. God's salvation is Christ Jesus. Not only is Jesus the law of the Lord, he is also God's righteousness. In his perfection, he gave his life that we might have forgiveness of sins, and with forgiveness we know we have life and salvation. The islands to which our text refers are the children of Israel who were exiled throughout the world, but they are also all Christians of all places, of all times. Again, Jesus did not come just to save a certain group of people. He came to give his life for all people, for you and for me. The last verse of our text is one that should make us stop and think. Verse 6. Lift up your eyes to the heavens and look at the earth beneath. The heavens vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment, and they who dwell in it will die in like manner. But my salvation will be forever, and my righteousness will never be dismayed. This is a verse that helps us point, remind us that we need to put our priorities in the right order, or at least it should make us think about the ordering of our priorities. As we reach the end of this church year, our Bible readings remind us that the Lord is coming sooner than we know and sooner than we might expect. Because the Lord is coming, we will want to be ready. Verse 6 reminds us that the heavens and the earth will vanish. The earth will be here no longer. But there is more. We are also reminded of the temporariness of all of our earthly possessions, our earthly stuff. We might ask ourselves, how much of our lives are we investing in the temporariness of this world, and how much are we investing in our eternity? Because about eternity, our text tells us that God's salvation will endure forever. God's salvation is that salvation earned for us by Jesus' death on the cross. How much of our lives are we investing in our salvation? God gave us his all. What do we give? Do we give according to what we think God or our church deserves? Or do we give according to what God has first given to us? Remember, what we are born with and what we take with us is what is truly ours. Nothing in this world is ours. It is simply ours alone from God. So do we give 1 hour a week? Do we give 2 hours a week? God gave us all. And God gives us 168 hours in a week. How are we investing our time? It said in the business world that time is money. How are we investing our money? How are we investing the gifts, talents, and abilities our Lord has given to us? Are we investing them in the things of God? Or are we so busy with the busyness of this world that we have little or no time? You don't have to answer that question. Indeed, our actions, our very lives, demonstrate what is most important in our lives. Lack of regular divine service, Bible class attendance, lack of giving time and service to the Lord, lack of giving time and treasures to the Lord shows our refusal of the gifts that he has to give. So let me ask you a question. If you knew that the end of the world would be next Sunday, would you live your life any different? Would you do anything differently? And before you answer that question, because if you answer yes, my next question is going to be, then why aren't you? Because we do not know when the world will end, that is, when the Lord will return, or when we will pass on and go to him. As we have been saying over the past several Sundays, it is imperative, most imperative, that we are always ready to meet our Lord. The text for today is once again points us to Jesus, to the cross of Christ. Remember, I always say we get it right when we point to Jesus. Jesus came to give us his all. He came to live for us in our place. Jesus came to live for us is the fullness of the gospel. Yes, Jesus came to die for us, but he also came to live for us perfectly in our place, which is what God demands of us, and we cannot do. Jesus came to give us all, because he knows that we in and of ourselves have nothing to give. Jesus lived for us so that by faith in him, faith that he also gives to us, faith we saw given to Caroline this morning, when God looks at us, he does not see us as sinful human beings. Indeed, he sees us in Christ's perfection. For the children of Israel, they had to look forward to the coming of the Savior. For us, we get to look back in faith and see God's promises fulfilled. We have God's word through which God gives us all his good gifts and blessings. Indeed, God gives us the whole lot of his gifts and a whole lot more. There are many in our world today who do not know God and his good gifts and blessings. And remember, God's salvation is for all people of all times and all places. His salvation is for us, but it's not for us to keep for ourselves. His salvation is for us to make known to others. As we reach the end of this church here, and as we know the end of the world cannot be far away, we will want to work with expediency to share God's word and salvation with others. So are you ready? Are you ready to meet the Lord? That really is what this day and what our lessons for today are asking. Are we ready? If we're not ready, now is the time to get ready. And we get ready by making use of those means that God has given us to get ourselves ready, his means of grace, his word, and his sacrament. We get ready by our changing our habits, by reading God's word, by remembering our baptism, by making use of confession and absolution, by partaking of his body and his blood and his holy supper, by making church attendance a priority and a regular habit. Indeed, by not refusing the good gifts and blessings he has to give, but by responding by giving ourselves first and then all other parts of our lives. If you are ready, indeed, praise the Lord. If we are ready, we show our readiness with the expediency with which we live our lives. My prayer is that the Lord will stir in your heart so that if you are ready, he will make you, if you're not ready, he will make you ready, and if you are ready, he will work through your readiness so that others might come to know him through you as well. And so that above all, in the end, we may all rejoice and say, to God be the glory, for Jesus' sake. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus and life everlasting. Amen. Having heard the word of the Lord, we respond by confessing our faith. This morning we do so with the words of the Apostles' Creed, as printed on page 159. Please rise. Confess our faith together.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
May you stand for our prayers. In our prayers for this morning, along with the prayers included in the bulletin, we add prayers for France for testing a 10-month-old grandson of a co-worker, Holly. We also pray for Kelly Perez, Shirley Coyle's grandson, Garrett Johnson's mother. She's being hospitalized for high blood pressure and has lupus. This morning, I would pray, Lord, in your mercy and ask that you respond. Hear our prayer. Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to Heavenly Father, you have revealed through created things destined for destruction, a kingdom that shall never be destroyed. In these gray and latter days, set the hearts of your baptized children on my class, and help us to be a people who truly wait with anticipation for the glorious appearing of Christ the King. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Kind, merciful one, your Son came into the world to bear witness to the truth. Open the mouths of all servants of your word and enable them to speak truly and boldly of Jesus and how he has loved us and freed us from our sins by his blood. Raise up ever new workers to spread your word and speak your promises. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Omnipotent one, your Son is truly the firstborn of the dead and the ruler of the kings of the earth. Remember in your mercy our presidents and Congress and all who bear office in our land. Give them wisdom to know what is right, courage to follow it, and integrity to do so in honor. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Teach the days you know the secret of our hearts. Give to us genuine repentance and faith that we may live ever mindful of your day of judgment, knowing that you alone can keep us from stumbling and present us blameless before the presence of your glory with great joy. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Grant, we pray that according to your gracious will, that Allie may return home soon. Thus we pray for the Lyles family, that you grant strength and faith in Christ, that they may bear under this burden and be at peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Grant, we pray, healthy children for Samantha and Serena. For safety for those in the military, Brittany, Joel, and Derek. For those with special needs, we pray, loving Father, the Donato family, Ted, Lisa, Sean, Garrett, Jordan, Ron, Barry, that you would keep them steadfast in trouble and comfort them. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
In the midst of heaven and earth that pass away, we beg you, Father, to strengthen by the words that will never pass away all who are in any affliction or trouble, heartache or pain, particularly your servants, the Harper family, Kelly, Cooper, Mike, Carol, Howard, Greg, Freeman, Betty, Clarence, Melanie, Mark, George, Josephina, Riley, Maria, Linda, Sandra, Mary, Lauren, Odette, Catherine, Loyal, Jay, Sharon, Dan, Bobby, Eileen, Pat, Cameron, Matthew, Charlie, Alice, David, Bobby, Marion, Janet, Carolyn, and all those we now name our hearts to for you. Remove from them all fear and help them to look forward to their full and final healing at the appearing of your Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father, glory in your Son, the Eucharist invites us to taste and see his goodness and love. Prepare our hearts to welcome him as he comes to us in his most holy body and blood. By this sacred gift, grant us the joy of forgiveness, the peace of your presence, and the hope of beholding our King's glory in the age to come. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Receive our thanks and praise for all those who died in the faith and bring us to share with them in the splendors of the new heaven and the new earth. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, we all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May you be seated. This time we got our first three tithes and offerings at the offering basket being passed around the record of fellowship book. You should find your food pew, please sign it and pass it on. If you're a first time guest, we ask for your address, then we may acknowledge your attendance with us this morning. We are celebrating the Lord's Supper this morning because of our care and concern for your spiritual well-being. We do practice the loving practice of closed communion. If you're a first time guest, we especially ask that you read our statement of our practice of the Lord's Supper found in the card in the pew in front of you. And if you should have any questions, please speak with me before approaching your statement to receive our offerings. places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. To you, Lord, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, from the night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he gave thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the same way also after the supper, he took the cup. And when he gave thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, drink it all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
We give thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this salutary gift, and we implore you that of your mercy, you would strengthen us through the same in faith towards you and in perfect love for one another. In Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you favor and give you peace.
Amen.